What is good, everybody in YouTube land? Welcome back to another installment of Counter Reaction. In today's episode, we're going to be looking at The Slashy Show from Easy Mill. Now, Banalo was a fucking banger. Loved that song. I've played that song probably like 15 plus times since I first listened to it. And I did watch the live freestyle version. That was dope as well. But this song was heavily requested. I don't know exactly what to expect because I haven't heard him outside of the other song. However, if I am using the last song as a measuring stick, I think he's gonna kill this one, to be quite honest with you. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into it.
Talking about this day, yeah. None of y'all turning 22 in 2020, and I'm from the 22 double O, no cap. It's my year.
I remember those days.
That's what I'm fucking talking about.
Welcome to my show. How's everybody doing?
You know, this reminds me of like the Dipset era where, you know, heat makers would always, they'd always sample like classic soul music. And Kanye's done it quite a few times as well. I'm really digging the vibes. I'm really digging the vibes of this beat for sure.
Fuel in the back. We're changing it up. Let's go. Yeah, whoa. Lately I've been pushing myself to my real limit. Lazy rapping, looking dumb, but I'ma still get it. Cause I'll be tripping on his beats like a little cricket. See me tongue and fly girls, I go rubber ribbon. Going fuck a midget, little sucker, get it done. Hit it like she number one.
Hold on. Tongue and fly girls. Tongue and fly girls. And then he kind of does the ribbit thing, so I'm assuming like a frog, frogs catch flies. With their tongue. Okay, I like that. I like that. It's subtle. It's subtle. But I like the way that he did the ribbit. Like that. That's an element in music that I can always appreciate. Is stuff like that. It's very creative. I think it's very creative. Instead of saying like a frog, he says rubba ribbit. I've never heard a frog do the rubba part, but I have heard a frog go ribbit. So I like that though. I like that line. So let's go back.
Yeah, whoa. Lately I've been pushing myself to my real limit. Lazy rapping, looking dumb, but I'ma still get it. Cause I'll be tripping on his beats like a little cricket. See me tongue and fly girls, I go rubber ribbon. Going fuck a midget, little sucker, get it done. Hit it like she number one, hit it wrong. Bet you think it's fun to be the...
Like a midget, little sucker. Okay, I like that. I like that too. Another very subtle one. Very subtle one. I still like it. There's like some word association there.
See number one, hit and run, bet you think it's fun to be the new bloke up in the alley who stoked. He fucked the tranny, who knows, you'll come in handy with bloke. Job sheets,
I'm sorry for the imagery. Come in handy is obviously a phrase for something that is available or accessible when needed. And then obviously come in handy with blow, and then he said jobs, so blow as in drugs, blow jobs. I like that. I like that a lot. It's a little off-putting, like the subject matter. I don't know exactly how it all fits, but it's still a dope line, literally. I like that a lot, actually, so let's go ahead and bring it back a little bit and go there.
Oh no, that she's loose and you still humping. Free our bro. Your pee now growth has completely stopped. Now you see now though, so go see the doc. Now you got a case of sex life injunction. Waste the whole verse on erectile dysfunction. Regular math problem y'all can never solve, and I'm proud of it, out of it, like a boy I'm scouting it. So if you're a girl, give me cookies, hey baby girl.
I'm gonna try not to be too critical, but yeah, the Boy Scouts, like a boy I'm scouting it. Okay.
I'ma put my genie in your lamp when I'm just talking to you. Don't you dare interrupt.
interrupt me when I'm in my room watching Hulu. I'ma make sure that every living being is gonna sue you. And
that part was, again, a little off-putting. I think that he's just kind of like on some rappy shit, right? He's just like, he's just trying to display his versatility and lyricism, which is perfectly fine. Just stringing random concepts together. But the whole Hulu thing, he brought it back. When he first said the first part, I was kind of like, But when he rhymed it with "when I'm watching Hulu," like that, I like that. That was dope. Okay, he surprised me with that one. I was like, where's he going with this? But okay, let's go back a little bit.
Out of it, like a boy, I'm scouting it. So if you're a girl, give me cookies, hey, baby girl, listen to me. I'ma put my.
And to be fair with the boy, I'm scouting it. He also brought in the cookies. Girl Scouts, Girl Scouts sell cookies. I don't know if Boy Scouts do. I don't think they do. I've never seen them if they do. But okay, so all right. I see it. Okay.
In your lamp when I'm just talking to you. Don't you dare interrupt me when I'm in my room watching Hulu. I'ma make sure that every living being is gonna sue you. And I'll be the prosecutor when watch you get cocked and neutered. And let's just sit. That's probably gonna dip.
Cocked and neutered? I know neutered is like, you know, you neuter. I think it's dogs, right? It's typically dogs that you neuter so that way they don't reproduce. But with the prosecutor line, I'm not too sure where he was going with that. Maybe it relates to the cocked and neutered part, like Johnny Cochran, but I don't think he was a prosecutor. I think he was a defense lawyer, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong. I don't know exactly where he was going with that one, but I mean, he's rapping his ass off. Like, I think what I'm going to do with this artist is take it slow. I think when there's an opportunity for me to be critical, I will. But I don't want to make the same mistake that I made with NF, which was not understanding him as an artist and what he brings to the table. Because had I known, right, or had I given it a chance, I feel like I would have been able to appreciate his music a lot earlier than I did. So I don't want to make the same mistake with this guy. So we're gonna rewind that back a little bit, and we're gonna try to finish this off strong.
And is gonna sue you, and I'll be the prosecutor when watch you get cocked and looted. And let's just sit. That's probably gonna dip. Like I'm on a trip. I don't roll the hip. Some of you rappers spitting bars, but you flow shit. Go back to the beginner, y'all. Y'all should grow a bit. Small, but you motherfuckers that just deserve to be in the back burner. You hit with a gap 30. You clip when it clack, gurgling shit like a rat. Turn to a bitch and a snitch on a cat. Hurting this kitten like that's murder. Ooh, damn. I just be spazzing too much. I think I need to get goodbye to get an attitude. Crush it. If you got an older V, well, you just have a loose touch. It. If you wanna go with me, well, I don't plan to lose. Clutch, motherfucker. Jump from the free throw line. Moonwalk through the air while rapping renegade. That's MJ. I could be a rap magazine where you look for metaphors. I'm a beatosaurus. That's Ben Ray. Give
it. I don't know what Ben Ray is, but I know the source is a magazine. So there's that. But the beginning part, it kind of threw me for a loop. I liked it, but there's like a part that I'm missing.
The bee in the back burner. You hit with a gap 30. You clip when it clack, gurgling shit like a rat. Turn to a bitch and a snitch on a cat. Hurting this kitten like that's murder. Ooh, damn. I just be spazzing too much. I think I need to get goodbye to get an attitude. Crush it. If you got an older V, well, you just have a loose touch. It. If you wanna go with me, well, I don't plan to lose. Clutch, motherfucker. Jump from the free throw line. Moonwalk through the air while rapping renegade. That's MJ. I could be a rap magazine where you look for metaphors. I'm a beatosaurus.
Okay, I see what he did there. That's pretty dope. That is pretty dope. I like that. I can't say that I liked the way that it was delivered, but it was dope. I feel like the way it was delivered is how I was able to get it, because it's not as simple as some might think. So there's a triple entendre there. There's MJ as it relates to jumping from the free throw line. And then there's the moonwalk, which is MJ, Michael Jackson. And then MJ as it relates to Eminem and Jay-Z, which they did a song called Renegade. It's all interconnected, and I like that. I like that. I think if it was delivered a different way, I might not have caught that. Probably a really genius decision to deliver it in that manner. So it's really good writing. He is just rapping on this beat for the sake of rapping. He's just putting his lyricism on display, which is an aspect of hip hop that is definitely missing. And I, for one, can appreciate something like this.
Light moonwalk through the air while rapping Renegade. That's MJ. I could be a rap magazine where you look for metaphors. I'm a beatosaurus. That's Ben Ray. Give it to what you want and be fly.
Okay, he can be the source. The source. Okay. Don't know what Ben Ray is. It could be, I honestly don't know. I'm not going to pretend like I know. Don't know what Ben Ray is. Maybe you guys can let me know down low in the comment section.
Kings do not get free thrones, so keep trying. Know that you're not alone anytime. Send me a feature, bro, you'll be fine. Why am I completely new to the dreamy mood? The ladies wanna meet me to relieve me, Lord. I do not wanna treat the rude. This PD tune will turn my brain to creepy goo with me, baby. So you're all this easy, dude, with a greedy clue. Go fuck yourself, that EDU, so stream me too. Go give my ass a sweet review. This is my show, bitch. Welcome to CD2.
Okay. Oh, that's a little rude. That was dope. But he did just eat the beat. He just ate that shit up and he had to release some of the gases. You know what I'm saying? I really like that. The last part, a little off kilter for me. Not too big of a fan of how long it went on. There was a point in there where I didn't really know what he was saying because he was putting on some sort of impression. But I liked it. It shows like he's got style. He's got some swag. Like he definitely displayed some style on this beat, which is super dope. Super dope. I'm excited to see what else he has in store for me. I absolutely love discovering new artists. But the next one should be up in a few days. So you guys all have something to look forward to. But now, does this make a playlist? No list? Or the blacklist? I don't know. It's kind of a toss-up. I feel like it's not as clear and cut as the first song that I listened to. That was an instant playlist banger. This one, it's not a banger. It's a dope listen. It's a dope first listen for sure. But it's not something that I would go back to and play. And that's not what this song was made for. This song was a, hey, fuck you, I know how to rap type song. But it was dope. So for those reasons, this one's going on like an office playlist. Like if I want to like show somebody a new artist and want to display their lyricism, I'm putting this song on that one and I'm gonna let it play through. In fact, it might not even be a playlist. I might just play dude's album. Like it's as simple as that. He's dope. Really, really enjoying his music thus far. But that's gonna be all from me. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and I'll catch you guys on the next one.